Cricket is known to be gentlemen's game and is regarded as one of the most prestigious games in the world. It is cricket which has one of the most following, probably seconded only by football. As a sport, cricket has a wonderful history and is full of interesting, funny, and amazing incidents that are spread over the course of this beautiful game. In this episode of How It Came to Be, we bring to you 15 such lesser-known but still amazing incidents of the game, where even the biggest self-proclaimed cricket fan might not know them all. So without further ado, let us take a look at them. At number 15 in the list is wicket of the 0th ball. Let us start with reigning king of cricket. Yeah, you got it right, he is none other than Indian prolific top-order batsman and current captain of Indian cricket team, Virat Kohli. The Indian team captain Virat Kohli is without a doubt, one of the best batsmen of this generation. But what about Kohli's bowling? Kohli rarely bowls right-arm medium pace when he is not thrashing the bowlers with the bat. But did you know Kohli had taken a wicket off the 0th ball in T20 cricket? In the one-off international T20 cricket match against England in 2011, Kohli was handed the ball for the first time in his T20 career. Then 23-year-old, Kohli bowled a wide ball on the leg side. But batsman Kevin Peterson charged down the track, only to miss the ball and stumped out by wicket-keeper MS Dhoni. So, technically Kohli didn't bowl a single ball in international cricket as his first ball was a wide, but since a stumping goes in the account of the bowler, he had a wicket. And hence, Virat Kohli's name has been registered in the record books for taking a wicket off the 0th ball. Number 14 in the list is India forfeiting a test match against arch-rivals Pakistan. When it comes to cricketing rivalry, nothing beats India versus Pakistan cricket. With passion and temper running so high, the thought of forfeiting a match is not even on the list of things that anyone could think can happen in a match between arch-rivals India and Pakistan. But Bishan Singh Bedhi, captain of the Indian cricket team playing against Pakistan in 1978, did the unthinkable and in the process became the first captain to concede an international cricket match. In this match, India needed just 23 runs from 14 balls with 8 wickets in hand when Bedhi decided to forfeit the game in protest of 4 consecutive bouncers bowled by Pakistani fast bowler Sarfraz Nawaz. The umpire had not called a single of them wide, and with no regulations about bouncers in an over back then, it wasn't against the rules. At number 13 is the longest test match in cricketing history. While there are talks of reducing international test cricket to 4 days per match, did you know that test matches were once a timeless affair and teams used to play until the definitive result was reached? In one such game in 1939, South Africa versus England test match went into the 10th day with England chasing 696 runs to win. They were at 654 runs with 5 wickets in hand at one position with just 42 more runs needed to win. The match only stopped because the captain of the ship which was supposed to take England back home refused to wait anymore and the game was declared drawn by the agreement. Imagine coming this close to chasing such a record total and not winning the game due to a person who wasn't even involved in the game. At number 12 is the shortest test match in cricketing history. 60 years later, after the longest test match in the history was played, England was once again involved and played one of the shortest test matches in the history of cricket, winning against West Indies by an inning and 39 runs in just under 2 days. West Indies were bowled out for 172 in the first innings and England took a lead of 100 runs thanks to Michael Vaughan's 78. But the Windies side was absolutely destroyed in the second innings by Andy Caddick and Darren Goff. The duo shared 9 wickets as the Caribbeans crumbled for 61 in just 26.2 overs. The game lasted for just over 150 overs and 2 days. At number 11 in the list is the only gameplay rule that never changed in the history of cricket. The laws of the game of cricket were written for the first time in the year 1774 by the Marylebone Cricket Club of London, commonly referred as MCC, and since then we cannot count as to how many times the rules have been changed. It's almost like a different game now from when it started. However, there is one rule that has stayed intact. And this rule is the length of the pitch, which is marked at 22 yards. Except this rule, every other rule has undergone some change. At number 10 in the list is maximum numbers of over in a trot by a fast bowler. Kapil Dev is a cricketing legend and the first Indian captain to win a World Cup for the nation back in 1983 with his all-round performance with both ball and bat. But Kapil Dev has pulled off another near-miraculous performance for India in a test match against West Indians. His 9 wickets for just 83 runs is famous amongst Indian fans, but very few know that he bowled 30.3 over on trot in that innings. A spell of 30.3 overs by a pace bowler, can't imagine anyone doing it today. At number 9 is most consecutive maiden overs in an inning. Bowling dot balls and maiden overs to keep batsmen tied up and frustrated enough to try rash shots is an art in itself. Repeating the feat, over after over, is something even the best bowlers find hard. But, India's Bapu Nadkarni, a left-arm orthodox bowler, perfected this art when he bowled 131 consecutive dot balls against England back in 1963. This is a record 21 maiden overs in a row. He finished with figures of 32 overs, 27 maidens, 5 runs and 0 wickets. At number 8 in the list is most runs in a single over. Most runs scored in a single over? 36 runs, right? No, that's wrong. Is it 40 to 45 runs in case of no balls or something like that? No, still wrong. The highest number of runs scored in a single over is 77 runs. Yes, you heard that right. In a game between Canterbury and Wellington in New Zealand's first-class cricket, Wellington's Bert Vance went for 77 runs in the only over he bowled. This is how the over progressed. Number 7 in the list is most career wickets taken. If making 200-plus centuries is remarkable, I don't know what the word for 4,000-plus first-class wickets is. Probably, the name of that wicket-taker. That word and the record goes to Wilfred Rhodes, who played for Yorkshire as an left-arm orthodox bowler and took 4,204 wickets in 1,110 career matches. At number 6 in the list is Sachin Tendulkar playing for Pakistan. Yeah, you heard this right. The son of India and arguably the best batsman of his time, Sachin Tendulkar once played for the Pakistani camp. Before Indian and Pakistani cricket fans go crazy, let me clear the air around this fact. Sachin was just a 13-year-old kid when he fielded for Pakistan. He acted as a substitute for Pakistan's Javed Miandad and Abdul Qadir, who left the stadium. Sachin dropped the catch of Kapil Dev once during this match while he was positioned at long on by Imran Khan. Not so much harm done then. At number 5 in the list is the holder of the first ever double century in one-day international cricket. We all are die-hard fans of Sachin Tendulkar, as he has given us lots of joy growing up. We associate most of the batting records with him. Actually, he does hold most of them too. A lot of people thought that he was the first player to score a double century in one-day international cricket when he scored 200 runs not out against South Africa in 2010. However, to the disappointment of the Indian fans, Sachin Tendulkar was not the first person to score 200 runs in ODI cricket. He was, though, the first male cricketer to do so. The first person to do so was actually Belinda Clark, arguably the greatest Australian batswoman ever. She did this against Denmark in 1997 when she scored 229 runs. At number 4 is batsman, retiring out. This is one of the most mind-blowing events in the history of Test cricket, and it happened in the Test match played between Sri Lanka and Bangladesh in 2001 in Colombo during the Asian Test Championship. In this match, the two batsmen were given retiring out. The former captain of Sri Lanka, Sanath Jayasuriya, made both Mahila Jayawardene and Marvin Attapattu retiring out. Attapattu, who was playing at 201 runs off 259 balls, and Jayawardene, who had scored 150 runs for 115 balls, were both retired out in the game. They were the first in the history to be retired out, making it one of the most bizarre cricket facts you will ever come across. At number 3 in the list is Test innings declared without scoring. This incident took place in a test match between England and South Africa in 1999, where the innings were declared for 0 runs for 0 wickets twice in the same test match. On the first day, South Africa scored 248 runs for 8 wickets as the rain washed out the second, third, and fourth day. So the captains, Nasser Hussain and Hansi Cronier, agreed to declare their second and third innings respectively to ensure a result. It was done in the spirit of the game. Hence, England effectively had to chase down 249 runs to win the test, which they eventually did. However, Cronier later revealed that he was paid by a bookie to ensure a result in the game. This became the central issue of the match-fixing saga of 1999-2000. At number 2 in the list is international batsman with only two toes. The swashbuckling Kiwi opener Martin Guptill is a two-toed batsman. He lost the other three toes in an accident when he was 14 years old. The New Zealand captain during that time was Stephen Fleming. He visited him in the hospital and let him know that he would play for New Zealand. Now, he is one of the best white ball openers and fielders in the world. What an inspirational story. And finally at the top spot in the list is cricketers who played in both football and cricket World Cups. Playing at a highest level to represent your country in cricket World Cup in itself a feat only few chosen ones can achieve. But there are two great cricketers on our planet who are blessed with such skills and talent that they have managed to participate and play in both cricket as well as football World Cups. West Indian great Sir Vivian Richards and Australian women cricket player Elise Perry are the only cricketers and in fact, the only two people in the world who have played both in World Cups of cricket and football. In 1974 Sir Vivian Richards played the qualifying matches for the Football World Cup for Antigua and then in 1975 and 1979 he was in the squad that played the Cricket World Cups for West Indies. Whereas Elise Perry played in the 2009 Women's Cricket World Cup and in 2011 was selected in the squad for the FIFA Women's World Cup in Germany. In the World Cup football group game against Norway, she came on as a late substitute. We are sure this is one of those unknown facts of cricket. Did you know this? Tell us in the comments. With this amazing feat of achievement by Sir Vivian Richards and Elise Perry, it's time to end the video. If you have enjoyed this episode, let me know by clicking the like button. Also, subscribe to the channel to keep receiving alerts of such interesting content. Goodbye, take care and see you soon on another interesting episode on How It Came to Be.